Be a company builder, you say.
Yeah, so in talking to a couple of employers, I learned that they are looking for company builders, especially the sort of startup companies. They're looking for people who are not out to just build their own career. They're out to build the company and help the company meet its goals. And so it means maybe having a job description that includes everything from repairing your equipment when it breaks down, or changing goals with the company at the drop of a hat. So you have to be sort of nimble and quick and ready to move with the company wherever it's headed. Mm-hmm. And it takes a certain mindset for an employee to work that way.
A little bit more entrepreneurial, like what's needed, fast afoot, flexible, open, would you say?
Absolutely. And so if somebody is not entrepreneurial and really wants more stability, there are also large-scale companies like Google and IBM and Cisco, that level company that's also moving into the green space. Mm-hmm. And they may have an entrepreneurial division that's moving into a new area. Mm-hmm. But that would give the employee a little more structure and a little more comfort.
Is that at all tied in with social responsibility or corporate? I mean, the image they're trying to put forward of what kind of company they are? Because I know some of them have departments.
Right, and that's a little different. The companies I just mentioned are actually building products and services for the green economy. IBM, we just saw, is looking at becoming a player in the smart grid software space. Mm. They also are looking at how to shift IT equipment so it requires less water to keep it cool. So a lot of the big companies are already looking at how they can get into this new economy, mostly because it's a great financial opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And you say track developments in the green economy in your field.
Yes. So gone are the days where you can just get in your job and say, okay, I'm done. I can just exist here. You have to track the green economy overall and then the developments in your field. Things are happening quickly. When I was researching my book, very often as I was looking into a particular industry and I'd put in a keyword into my search engine and it would pull up, I would find a huge announcement that had been made within the week.
Wow.
And that was throughout the entire book. Wow. And so things are changing rapidly. A new policy can make or break an industry. And if you work in that industry, you're going to want to know, are you heading toward boom times, or should you see the writing on the wall and start looking at how to transition into a related field?
Wow, that's amazing. It seems like you have to be much more creative and open than, because the change is coming at a faster and faster pace, right?
Yes. It's constant.
You'll be working on volume two. although your website will be somewhat of a bridge between the two, right?
Yeah, actually, we have a link in the book for updates, and we have just created a system where we'll have 50 industry trackers that are helping us track developments. They're volunteers, and they're helping us track developments in different industries.
Wow.
So we can keep up with what's the development in solar, what are the developments in green textiles. You know, it's just wide open.
It's kind of exciting, huh?
It is very exciting.
So let's talk about your book. It's
sure.
So hot, we have just a little mock-up of it.
Yes, if you this can is hold a it. Mock-up of the book.
Let's see if it can be seen there.
Yeah.
So tell us about the book.
So Green Careers for Dummies, it's my third Dummies book. Mm-hmm. And so I was fortunate enough to have the opportunity to write about what I love, which is all this innovation. And in the book, we talk about the green economy and giving people that foundation information they need. And then we help them sort out what's their green focus, their green niche. And we have 7 chapters of industry profiles where we literally describe the industries, 45 to 50 industries with their current trends, future trends, resources that they can go and look at. And it's a huge part of the, 7 chapters of a book is a big portion of the book.
Mm-hmm.
And then we also have strategies to help people prepare for their job search and then actually launch their job search.
Wow. So does it also help them a little bit? I know it's not a dictionary, but does it help people get their arms around some of the terminology so they know how to talk about things?
Yes. I feel very strongly that if you are going into the green economy, you must understand the terminology because it's different. You know, mm-hmm. the same words we've been using but now they suddenly have a new meaning. And if you're in an interview or networking with a contact and you don't know what a certain term means, you better go figure that out. And we have a lot of terms in the book.
Yeah, it seems like clean technology is becoming a pretty standard. Would you say that that's a very similar green technology and clean technology would be somewhat synonymous? Or?
No, they're not synonymous, but they have similar goals at one level. Clean tech is really looking at the most effective and efficient way to manufacture something in a cost-effective way. So it has some of the same outcomes.
Green is more
general. Green is really focusing on the impact on the environment. So lowering carbon emissions and other greenhouse gases, reducing waste. So the clean tech, it's a murky field, and even the clean tech sites that define themselves have some interesting perspectives on that. But one thing I think of is for clean tech is it's an umbrella sector. It's actually an investment term. Investors were investing in a certain group of or collection of industries, and they're very wide ranging. Everything from solar and wind to materials. They don't fit into any industry structure you've ever heard of. And so I like to think of it as an umbrella sector where all of these 14 different industries fall in under that, and their goal is all to do things more efficiently and resource conservation.
So tell us briefly, we're coming close here to the end, about your website and maybe some advice you'd give to somebody out there kind of afraid of the whole thing and trying to figure out.
Yeah.
Those are two different questions, but I'm trying to
I can weave those in.
Yeah.
So my website is Green Career Central, and we are an online resource.
Actually, I only have 30 seconds, so I'm sorry.
a green career resource for professionals, students, and career counselors. And we have articles and resources and classes and newsletters, all sorts of different things. And I would say the best advice is to start. Even if you don't want to change jobs right now, start becoming familiar right now. Now is the time to begin to prepare. Even if you don't change jobs for 3 years, you can use this 3 years or 2 years or 1 year to improve your skills, improve your knowledge, get your network together, and you'll be a lot farther along than if 2 years from now you decide, oh, I want a green career, and then you've got to do all this homework.
So act now.
Act now.
Great.
Thank you
for being on the show.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching You're Hired. If you have any questions about this show, suggestions for future shows, or questions about jobs and careers, feel free to email me at steve@bayareacareercoach.com. And do check out the website. We've got the 12 keys to getting a great job. Can find out about the coaching I do there. And also, I'm putting the contact information of everybody who's been on the show so they can contact you. And your website again?
GreenCareerCentral.com.
Okay. And to contact me, feel free to contact me at www.bayareacareercoach.com. Again, it's www.bayareacareercoach.com. Sounds like you're doing some great work.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching our show, and we'll see you next time on You're Hired. Thanks for being on You're Hired.
Sure.
There's a really nice connection between what you were doing before with the dream career and what you're doing.
Yep.
I mean, you're kind of living the dream a little bit.
I am. Yeah.
Is it exciting to you?
Oh, every day.
Really?
Yep, every day. My husband and I are working.